Notice Me. That's like the shortest tune on the album, and it literally just says, "Didn't you notice me standing alone throughout?" Even though it sounds nothing like it, it was stemming from a Nick Drake tune. He says in that, "Why leave me hanging on a star when you deem me so bright?" Basically, so it's kind of like, because he died prematurely, really, for getting fame or any kind of recognition towards his music, which is really sad. And considering how talented he was, and how many musicians and people just love his music now. No samples actually in this album. It's all recorded by me, done by me, kind of thing. So it was all very much like stemming from either playing something on the guitar or the keys. I was using this old Casio keyboard at the time, and I kept sort of playing with some random sounds on that, and that sort of geared up a few of the tunes. Sometimes I just literally just randomly pluck a chord or play, you know, like, I'm not the best keys player, but I know what I'm doing enough, but sometimes I just literally slap my fingers on roughly in a place where I know it's going to sound alright, and then that can inspire something. First tune was I Can't Believe It's You, which I've just called Believe It, I think, but the words in it are just I Can't Believe It's You, and it was kind of a sort of mantra almost to myself that I'd rediscovered how to make music again for me, rather than just like trying to make house music or trying to make, you know, a specific genre, and that definitely affected the sort of emotive side of the music. On music, they love it, you know. My dad used to basically just play loads of music really loud, but he used to play all sorts of different stuff, from like, you know, the Clash to Bob Marley to the Pogues to, like, you know, just really some classic stuff, some just all over the shop, which kind of led us to just having our own personal music tastes from an early age, you know. And then my mum, actually I'd say my mum's not a musician, she does play the piano actually. She like reads music and that kind of thing, she's not a sort of improv sort of style as what I do, but it's having a piano in the house, it always, you know, it helps kind of thing. Title of the album itself, Millennial Falcon. I think everyone that listens to it will probably think, oh, I must be like a big Star Wars fan, which is to an extent true. I used to love the original trilogy. And then Millennial, kind of, I just threw that in because it's quite fitting with me. Generally, I quite often get zoned into one task and I kind of just forget about the whole, you know, everything else that's going on. Me and my brother kind of did this little mock-up design that kind of, it, more of a feeling than anything, and it was like this young person sat in a spaceship control with all this universe going on around them, but they just sat looking at the phone, you know, not paying attention to what's going on.